Greetings from Istanbul Technical University. I'm Burak, team captain of IT Rover Team, and here is our 6th generation rover.
Two different chassis designs used in this year's rover. 2mm aluminum sheet metal body for easy production and carbon fiber chassis for solidity and lightness. A differential bar and tracker suspension mechanism have chosen for raising field performance. The height of the rover from surface is 0.3 meter, including wheels, the width is 1 meter and length is 1.1 meter. Steering mechanism is developed for superior movement capability. It provides us to steer every wheel independently and accurate control for rover's motion. Brushless DC motors has been installed on each wheel's hub for better protection from outer effects. Airless tires that manufactured from TPU by 3D printing are designed more dish to reduce contact with ground.
In this year's rover, we used STM32 microcontroller and VESC electric speed controller zone thrusting system. As a result of using brushless DC motors with Hall effect sensors, we can control the thrusting system more precisely, get important data such as RPM, power, and use it on the PID controller design. For the steering, Talon SRX motor drivers and magnetic absolute encoders are utilized. In the electronics box, 4 custom-made PCBs are designed and implemented for the power and data distribution throughout the system to make the system as organized and modular as possible.
Connection between microcontrollers and onboard computers is built with serial communication. Long-range communication between the ground station and the rover is established using 2.4 GHz RF modules. Directional antenna is rotated according to the location of the rover for achieving more robust and longer-range communication. To have a better perception on the rover, IP and FPV cameras are located on the different spots. Our algorithms are tested in simulation which designed for the competition tasks. In this way, problems can be observed in advance. Complete control on the rover is provided during tests thanks to our new user-oriented interface.
Our Rover 6-axis robotic arm is designed with a worm gear and cycloidal gearboxes mechanism that will provide the required torque and full rotation for the each axis. The structural parts of the robotic arm are made of carbon fiber and aluminum to achieve maximum strength. The two-fingered adaptive gripper, consisting of PETG and aluminum parts, allows you to easily hold on any shape of an object with the help of TPU pads used in the fingers. 7 brushed DC motors are used to drive the robotic arm and the gripper.
Talon SRX motor drivers for each axis and precise encoders helps us to achieve accurate position control. Communication of the system is done via CAN bus, which is a robust protocol. Additionally, in order to provide flexibility and safety, we took extra care to cable management.
This year, we made our robotic arm even more fail-proof by improving the interface between hardware and software. For teleoperation, besides integrating industry-proven solutions into our system, we also developed our own inert kinematic solutions as an alternative. As a result, we are capable of controlling the robotic manipulator precisely in both Cartesian space and joint space. This way, optimum motion can be obtained for various tasks. In addition, we developed each of our systems by repeatedly testing them in simulation and performing drill missions in real life.
Steering system is configured for autonomous navigation and teleoperation. With the SLAM algorithm, a cost map is obtained using the 3D map constructed from the accumulated point cloud data. While orientation of the rover is consolidated by 2 AMUs, localization is improved using 1 GPS at the base station and another on the rover. By adding plugins and customizing the navigation stack, the autonomous movement is stabilized. AR tags are found by a spiral searching algorithm. Tags are detected by the Aruko in the short range, and YOLO is used for extending the detection range. A concurrent state mission system is implemented in order to control the status of the rover and the sensors, while simultaneously ensuring the autonomous navigation of the rover.
In this new science system, we set out with the experience we gained from past years. While the soiling and transportation process was simplified and prevented from contamination with the drill mechanism, a complex system has been developed for the transformation and filtration of required chemicals. Also, the microscope was added to spectrometer mechanism for increasing the accuracy of the results of examination. DC and stepper motors are used together in the system that aims to increase strength by using patchy material.
After the samples are taken to obtain the organic molecules, soil is filtered from the Wattmann paper. Shifts and Bradford reagent were used to detect aldehyde and protein molecules. These assays only take a few minutes, and results are detected by IT Rover Science Laboratory.
Glucose biosensor was produced to detect the glucose, which is main energy source for microbial life. Chitosan cryogel was produced in our laboratory and analyzed by SEM. Glucose oxidase and peroxidase enzymes were immobilized on cryogel by cross-linking.
Artificial intelligent algorithms were used to detect the rock samples. Rocks were photographed and examined with a microscope, and a percentage of similarity was obtained.
atmospheric gas, humidity and temperature sensors were used to measure the habitability of the environment, and they were compared with the reference data from Earth and Mars atmosphere.
Raman and visible near infrared spectrometers are designed to identify the rock and soil samples. In the Raman spectrometer, a 532 nanometer monochromatic light source is used. The mid switch was used to confirm the angle of the mirror, which leads us to find the Raman peaks in the spectrum, which scanned by the photodiode. In the visible spectrometer, a polychromator light source is used, and we prepared our own database.